it's one of those things where you remember what was it like not to have nothing.
Yeah.
So I just couldn't go and burn it on something because.
When did you feel like, yo, I'm actually in this, like Elie Seckbach, like I'm here, like I'm really in this motherfucker, like.
Just recently, like a year ago, 2 years ago, the WBA invited me to a big event that they had, and they gave me an award for my contribution to boxing. Like,
I feel like, honestly, I'm going to be honest with you, I feel like you're going to end up in the Hall of Fame. You've done so much. You've done so much for boxing.
I'm not part of the cool kids table. I'm not part of the...
They're going to do it.
They're all... Everybody in boxing is sliced from the same loaf of bread. I'm not part of that loaf of bread. I don't have the voice, the look, the connections.
They're going to put you in.
They're going to put you... I'm calling this out right now.
You contributed somewhere to
boxing. I'm calling this out.
If it happens, it's great, but I don't believe it's going to happen because I'm not part of the inner clique. Everybody's very cliquish in boxing. You know what I mean? Like,
yeah.
We should do a poll. Should Elie be in the Hall of Fame?
Yeah. No, I
let's do that.
Because look, what he has contributed to boxing is
unbelievable. Bro, he's done so much. From my pro debut, and I was, you know, I'm still nobody, but.
You know how many views, when I covered the NBA, I had 10 million views in three years on YouTube of covering the NBA, 10 million views. And I thought that was like, wow, incredible.
Yeah.
10 years of you boxing on YouTube in 10 years, something like 870 million views. And I'm saying, but the impressions is times three, so that means people watching shit twice.
Share,
yeah.
All that stuff, you know.
It's crazy, but that's where social media changed boxing. Because there was no social media, you'd have to rely on HBO once in 3 months, and Showtime, and that's it. An article once in a blue moon. There's no real radio show about boxing.
There's not.
I mean, there are radio shows, but I'm talking about, if there's a fight tonight where Manny Pacquiao's fighting Mikey, and I'm driving, and I want to hear the thing on the radio. Does that exist?
Yeah, no.
What, doesn't Mike Tyson do the hot boxing thing?
No, I'm talking about... fighting Abraham. Abraham Martinez is fighting...
I mean, you have to hope that they're on the radio commentating.
Oh, well, I try to watch the Instagram live stories while Rolly's driving or somebody. I'm like, how's he doing? Nah, he's doing good. Or,
yeah,
you know.
Exactly. But I'm saying about something like organized, like basketball, baseball, football. You know, they broadcast.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But boxing, we don't have that. There's social media, and everybody streams, and everybody...
Yeah.
Twitter people be tweeting what's going on in the fight, you know?
But I'm not a big fan of that, because if you're a reporter, and you're tweeting, that means you're not watching the action.
Yeah.
There's no way you could tweet and watch an action at the same time, because you have to look at what you're doing, send, right?
Yeah.
Blackberries, maybe you could do it, but not with iPhones.
He's right. You're 100% right.
That's why when they score fights, I'm like, you didn't watch the fight.
No, my favorite one is when they're like, man, I had that fight as a split decision. How the fuck do you have a fight as a split decision? Like, a split decision means that there's like three.